The opening ceremony of the 28th Winter Universiad may be on Sunday, but competition is underway here in Almaty. In men's hockey action, we'll take a look in on Slovakia and Great Britain, Japan and Latvia, as well as Kazakhstan and China. While in women's competition, Canada will take on China as well. The Halyk Arena, site of men's ice hockey here at the 28th Winter Universiad in Almaty. Kicking off hockey action here, it'll be Slovakia and Great Britain in Group B action. There you get a look at Group B, tough group with Canada and the United States also part of this foursome. There you get a look at Juraj Halo, the starting goaltender for Slovakia. He plays his hockey with HC Topolčany. It's his second universiad, and there you get a look at the British team. Their starting goaltender will be Adam Long. He plays with the Peterborough Phantoms, 21-year-old goaltender. Captain Martin Unak for Slovakia and Alex Samford for the British team. They'll exchange gifts. Starting lineup for Slovakia. And there you get a look at the starting lineup for Great Britain. And men's hockey action underway here in Almaty. And it will not take long for Andrej Vibo and his Slovakian team to capitalize. Shorthanded here, wrist shot deflected in front. That's Edmund Piačka. And he will get the deflection to put Slovakia up 1-0. Get a good look at it here. Just a little tip right in front goes up and over the shoulder of Adam Long. And Slovakia takes a 1-0 lead. Just minutes later, a great little tip pass there. Ivan Jakubik holds the puck. Long can't stay with him, and Jakubik scores his first of what will be a big night for him. Michael Kabach and Martin Unak with the assist on the second Slovakian goal. Slovakia right back at it as Gapa. That one off the crossbar. And now it is Great Britain. Not a lot of chances for them on the night, but there's Samford, a double deflection right in front, and a great save by Hollow. Get a good look at it here. There's the first tip. Samford just turns and fires off the deflected skate in front, and Hollow with a nice stop. Slovakia keeps coming though. Turnover by the British right in front of their net. And that one stopped by Long, but the second one can't be. Hluk buries it. And that puts Slovakia up 3-0. There you see the stop initially, but the second one eludes Adam Long. Shots on goal, 21-4 in favor of Slovakia after the first period. Now move into the second period, early here in the second frame. Shot in front, deflected up and over the arm of Adam Long. That's Piačka with his second of the night. You get a good look at it there off the shot from Pichnarczyk. 4-0 Slovakia. Pichnarczyk will factor into the second goal. That wrister goes right by Adam Long. Piačka though with the assist there. Adam Long never even saw it. He would be removed after that one. Matthew Coyle came in. Shots on goal 45-7. Slovakia all over Great Britain through 40 minutes. 3 minutes into the third period. An open net there for Jakub Loidl on the power play. Coyle lost sight of it in front. As you see the replay there, the initial stop, and the puck will just kind of float back in front. And it's Brezhnev able to fire it home. 6-0. Now here's Jakubek. He holds, and a great little touch in front as he holds the puck. Coyle little off his goal line there. You'll see it here, and just tucked home there, Jakubik for his second of the night, an unassisted marker. Coyle thought he had the post, but Jakubik tucked it in behind. Now with 6:19 to go, Thomas Hluk with his second of the evening, off the rebound on the initial Coyle save. Now just over 3 minutes left. Ivan Jakubik, we said earlier he'd have a big night. And there you see his hat-trick goal. Ivan Brezhnev with the initial shot. And Jakubik gets his third. And that's how it'll finish, 9-0. Slovakia opens up men's hockey competition here with a big win over Great Britain. Shots on goal 61-13 in favor of Slovakia. They go 2-for-7 on the power play. Jakubik with the 3 goals, Martin Nunak 3 assists, and Edmund Piatka 2 goals and 1 helper.
Welcome to Group C of the ice hockey competition at this 28th Universiad. And today's match between Japan and Latvia here at the Halyk Arena. Latvia start favourites, but the favourites in the group are the Russian Federation, the Russians the defending champions, Korea the fourth team in the group. Stefan Hogarth from Great Britain and Christian Bopersen of Sweden, your match referees today, as Japan make their way onto the ice. There on the right of your picture, Latvia to the left. As always, nervous times for the first group game. Final adjustments, Furukawa, Matsukane, Watanabe, Hitosato, Katsuragawa, and Deguchi. The Japanese starting lineup. Gins Pikars, the coach of Latvia, looking slightly nervous. His team Janssen, Zemins, Delevka, Zolmanis, Petkus, and Mitsuts. In your face, that's the name of the game. And there's the face-off, we're up and running. And it's Japan in possession. Interested fans, Japan on the break. And what a start, dream start for the Japanese side. Deguchi, wonderful assist. And the goal scorer, Shigeki Hitosato. Trademark goal by the Japanese. And here they come again. And that goal scored in the first minute, and there's another one. Unbelievable. Japan are flying 2-0. That was Kodai Matsumoto. Lovely assist by Seiyo Furukawa. Latvia are reeling. They need to get back into the game, and they have. Just before the end of the first period, Olaf Zaplocks in the right place at the right time. Just going in off the side of the post. 2-1 to the Japanese at the end of the first period. And my oh my, what a crucial time for Latvia to score. Everybody getting into the spirit here at the Halyk Arena. Thrills and spills. That gravity-defying stuff. A bit of argy-bargy. You'd expect that in ice hockey at any level. Throwing yourself into the challenge. Latvia on the ball. Oh, what a goal! Stunning strike! You will not see a better finish all competition. Kristis Apstitis, the left-hander. And here they come again on the counter-attack. Another goal! 2 goals in 3 minutes for the Latvians. They lead 3-2. Sandis Grinbergis. Wonderful speed, balance. And the Japanese coach, he's on the ropes there. Well, in a much better place now, Latvia, at the end of the second period than they were at the first. Looking pretty. What can Japan do? Well, they mustn't handle the puck, that's for sure. The nerves and the occasion getting to them. What a stop! That is a superb save by Shun Furukawa. Now, if that had gone in, I think it could have been game over. Good effort by Oleg Sislanikov. He actually thought he'd scored. Kazuyoshi Yamaguchi. Heaving a sigh of relief. Another good stop. That time by the Latvian keeper, Petkus. Japan come again, and this time they score. There's the equaliser. 5 minutes left in normal time. Another trademark goal, just like the second, in fact. That time, Kata Deguchi. And there is the end of normal time. Crucial goal for the Japanese. 3-3 at the end of the hour play. She looks downhearted. She needn't. The team is still in it. Loose ball. Goalman scramble. And it's in the back of the net. Wonderful start into overtime for Latvia. Piling the pressure on. Well, the goalkeeper did his level best. Martins Metzoulis with the final effort. He was scrappy, but they won't mind that. Final score here then. Latvia 4, Japan 3. Disappointment for the Japanese. Joy for Latvia. Japan will have a chance to bounce back against Korea, their South Asian rivals. Latvia, they face Russia.
By the time Kazakhstan lined up against China, the Halyk Arena was well and truly full and bouncing. This wasn't just the 2013 and 2015 silver medalists opening their campaign against a China side hoping to bring in the year of a rooster on a positive note. This was the hosts in front of their home crowd. And in hockey terms, it was to prove men against boys. The rooster in danger of going in the pot. China's record 2 years ago was woeful in Slovakia. They conceded 54 goals in six games. So goals were expected and the crowd wasn't to be disappointed. It didn't take the hosts long to assert themselves in this game. Vladimir Grebenshikov, one of three survivors from the Kazakh silver medal winning squad in Slovakia 2 years ago, got the opener after just 72 seconds. The assist coming from Kirill Savitsky and Anton Petrov. Great way for Kazakhstan to start the match. And it got even better, because 27 seconds later, Alikan Asitov added the second. Neat interchange, no hope really for the Chinese goalkeeper. And from that point on, the goals just rained in. This one steered home by Alexei Ansifarov. 39 shots on the Chinese goal in that first period. The Kazakhs 9-0 up. In that first period, although coach Sergei Starygin might wonder about the chances that went a-begging. The poor old China, it didn't bode well for the rest of the match. Statistics. The main one, 9-0. Well, the change around brought no peace for the beleaguered Chinese. 58 seconds after the restart, Konstantin Sedenkov teed up Artem Burdalev for his third goal of the evening and Kazakhstan's 10th. Another fine finish. The hosts were down by a man when Dmitry Grenz was sent to the sin bin for high sticking. But that didn't affect the flow of the game. The Chinese struggling to get close to the Kazakh goal. Kazakhs laying siege at the other end. Berdalev back on, scored from close range, grabbing his fourth to make it 13-0. The alarm bells ringing in the Chinese camp as they remembered the 13-goal thrashing they received at the hands of the Slovaks 2 years ago. And then 20-year-old Alikan Asitov clambered into the action. He scored two goals in the space of 3 minutes to complete his hat-trick. That slap shot, good enough to put the Kazakhs 15-0 up at the end of the second period. Toughest of challenges lying in wait for China in the third period, trailing by 15-0. Didn't upset the home crowd, though. They were happy to see this goal fest. One change for the Kazakhs. They brought on Pavel Poloektov in goal for Sergei Kudryavtsev. He must have wondered what he had done wrong. Didn't stop the Kazakhs from pouring in more goals. Burdalev collecting his fifth of the evening. And Yaroslav Yevdokimov rounded off a 22-0 victory. It's an extraordinary show of power from the Kazakhs. 102 shots on goal. an icy Chinese burn. Sweden will pose stiffer opposition for the hosts in their next game on Tuesday, while the Chinese must pick themselves up quickly before they take on the Czechs on Wednesday.
Once the dominant nation in women's university ice hockey, Canada launched their quest to regain supremacy in their opening preliminary match. First opponents, the Chinese, who missed out on a medal altogether 2 years ago in Grenada. Seven women's teams are competing in Almaty, Canada and China drawn into the four-team Group A, also containing Great Britain and Northern Ireland, plus the host nation Kazakhstan, with the top two in the standings after each of the team's three games going directly to the knockout semi-finals. With the men playing at the Hayek Arena, the women are playing 12 kilometres away across the city at the Balawan Sholak Sports Palace. The match officials for this first game led by Swedish referee Evi Maria Bergkliff. Canada is led by captain Caitlin Goslin, a defender keen to forget the pain of losing the final 2 years ago. China are looking to wipe away the memory of their bronze medal match defeat in Grenada to the Japanese, starting goalie Wang Zhuhing needing a big defensive performance from the other starters in the Chinese lineup. Canada are looking to reclaim the gold medal. They lost to Russia 3-0 in the 2015 championship game in Spain. And it wasn't long before the team that won the first three titles after the introduction of women's ice hockey to the Universiade in 2009 scored in the first period of their first game this year. Catherine Bailey's slap shot through the crowd at 3:42 on the clock. Having assisted on the first goal, talented newcomer Melody Bouchard was on target herself less than 3 minutes later after a nice skate with the puck and reverse pass from Alana Sharman. Then it was Sharman's turn to score at 8:33 gone in the period, Bouchard returning the favour with a sharp assist from the side of the net, with Caden Willoughby also again involved. 3-0 at the end of the first period. Women's hockey made its Universiade debut in 2009 in Harbin, China. Canada won the first three titles in 2009, 11 and 13, before Russia dethroned them in the final for their first title at the most recent edition in 2015. Into the second period here, and Canadian skipper Goslin laid the puck off to Kylie Gavelin, who crossed the rink before feeding it in towards goal, where JC Lee Magwood pounced in front of the Chinese goalie for 4-0. Then a free-for-all right in front of goal led to the Canadian fifth a minute or so later. Jessica Cormier in amongst the bodies before Alexandra Labelle grabbed the final touch for the goal. Then a second goal of the game for 22-year-old Bouchard. Willoughby continuing her penchant for assists as well, picking up the puck behind the goal and skating back round into the danger area. Her shot was stopped, but Bouchard snapped up the rebound. After nearly two full periods of defending, the Chinese, who were somewhat battered, suddenly presented themselves with a chance to score. Kelly Murray tripped in possession and He Jing raced away to beat Canadian goaltender Valerie Lamenta with some style. However, it was only a blip for the Canadians, and they scored again on a power play. Daly Ann Oddie found Kelty Apperson. Her shot was deflected by Kong Minghui, but the puck went straight to Kelly Gribbins, who scored with just 35 seconds of the period remaining. 7-1 heading into the final 20 minutes of action at the Sports Palace, named after Balwan Sholak, the famous Kazakh wrestler, writer and composer. Not a stressful opening game for the orchestrator of this Canadian performance, coach Rachel Flanagan, who was the assistant coach with Canada's gold medal winning squad in 2013 in Italy, the last time her nation won the title. Her side may have been cruising to victory, but that doesn't mean they were backing off. Murray sent from the ice for a two-minute penalty for tripping Kong Minghui. In her absence, the Chinese went on the attack too. Canadian captain Goslin taking the puck down the boards, but her progress abruptly halted by China's assistant captain Fang Jin, with the pair of them taking out the match official as well. Moving forward, China's Deng Di with the slap shot here, saved by Canadian goalie Lamenta, but Liu Shuang was unable to get the first touch control needed to put away the rebound. The Canadians, though, were proving more clinical. Abson finding Brianna Yazzolino at the point. Her shot rebounded in front of Rachel Marriott, who didn't need a second invitation to make it another goal, with both teams back to full strength 10 minutes from time. Chinese goalie Hu Xie made one of her 13 saves after she'd replaced starter Wang Zhuqing, who'd gone off, having faced 42 shots on goal from the Canadians. There was still enough appetite in the Canadian camp for another piece of scoring action. Oddie, like her captain, played in the final loss to Russia 2 years ago, and here she struck home a shot off the post to complete the scoring with just over 2 minutes remaining. 9-1, the final score then. A thumping win for the three-time former champion Canadians, and a demoralisingly comprehensive drubbing for the Chinese. Next up for the Canadians are the British on Monday. On the same day, China faced the host, Kazakhstan.